Hello, everyone. My name is Jing Zhang. I'm the Business Management Director at Synopsys, responsible for VC Formal. Today, I'm speaking with Jia Zhu. Jia has been with AMD for the past 16 years as verification engineer, then verification manager, driving verification for blocks and IPs and setting up verification methodologies and infrastructure. Currently, Jia is leading the central formal verification team to drive all formal verification practices for AMD's next generation GPU, including infrastructure, methodology, and execution. Jia has a bachelor degree in computer science and master degree in microelectronics. Welcome, Jia.
Thank you, Jing, for having me today.
Yeah, so the topic of my conversation today is about using formal technology for design exploration, because I know you have been championing this effort at AMD. So my first question to you is, why formal technology is a good solution for designers to use for design exploration?
Yeah, I think as a formal verification engineer, we usually start our FPV work from cover properties rather than assertions. You can call it design exploration or design wiggling. So it can help us to understand the basic behavior quickly and have a basic idea of the complexity, right? So for example, how many cycles does it take to complete a transaction? Or is there any cover property hard to hit? So I think design exploration with formal tour is something well accepted by formal verification engineers. And then nowadays, we are seeing a trend that more and more designers find it's very useful to use formal verification tour to explore the design. A designer may take the ownership of some legacy design without good documentation, or a designer may want to do some smoking test on the new RTL code. For all those cases, design exploration would be very helpful. So it's beyond the formal verification itself and be more and more popular in design community.
So for designers to use formal solution for exploration, are there any specific, you know, capabilities or features formal tool needs to have to enable this community of users?
Yeah, I think in the past, as dedicated formal verification resource, we wrote cover property all by ourselves, right? But nowadays, you can leverage VC Formal's navigator to generate waveform quickly in your GUI. So I think that this reduced the learning curve for designer to quickly adopt this very powerful and useful tool. So you can inspect the waveform, then edit it easily. So I think this interactive process makes the design exploration much more efficient than before. And by the way, VC Formal integrated Verdi into your GUI platform, right? So, and Verdi has a very big user base. So I think this also lowered the bar for designers to leverage this cutting edge technology. So sometimes we found that it could be possible for you to find some RTL bugs during the exploration stage. At that time, maybe you don't have any assertion, right? But with our design exploration, you can find some RTL bugs.
Yeah, that's an excellent point on Verdi, because we know designers love Verdi. So yeah, having VC Formal built on top of Verdi for debugging or navigation is definitely a plus.
Yes.
Now, I know you said formal engineers have been doing design exploration for a long time, and this is sort of new for designers. Why is that? And what benefit can you spell out? I know you've talked about that in the, you know, answers prior, but can you summarize the benefit so that we can encourage more designers to use formal for exploration?
Yeah, I'm very happy to add more color. So I think the biggest benefit actually is the module level test bench is no longer necessary, right? So nowadays, the mainstream simulation solution is UVM, but it's not some lightweight solution. So you need to, for example, import UVM package. You need to follow all those UVM guidelines. not to mention that it takes time for someone to study UVM, right? So some designers still choose to use Verilog to develop the union level testing environment. And we all know that Verilog isn't expressive enough for verification, right? So sometimes the designer may create some vector file, then use the Verilog test manager to read the vector file, then drive those input stimulus to the DUT cycle by cycle. It's very tedious, and it's also error prone. So sometimes you will introduce more issues into your environment, right? So, I think the other option many designers adopt is just to skip the union level testing, right? Then leave this to professional verification engineer. The drawback of this solution is that the verification is shifted right instead of shifted left, right? Because you actually create a lot of dependency. To make a UVM test bench, to make simulation get running, you need to have your test bench ready, you need to have your all duty ready, and you need to have your reference model ready, right? So which means, the RTL coding may already be there, but you cannot kick off your simulation. So with formal verification, we can actually have a new agile development methodology, right? So whenever any module is ready, designer can do design exploration and try some early bug hunting to flush out those basic issues all by themselves. So there's no dependency at all, and if designer is willing to adopt, for example, assertion-based design, assertion-based verification, they can create their own assertion, cover properties, assumptions, and all those things can be reused later on. For example, reused in simulation, reused by a dedicated formal verification engineer, and reused in hardware emulation. So I think this can significantly change the our IC design process and make agile development methodology a mainstream solution. And formal verification is the right tool to help us shift left again.
Well, thank you. I think you spell out beautifully why formal should be used by designers to do exploration, right? Mm-hmm. To left shift project cycle and get quality design done early. So thank you so much, Jia, for sharing your insight. And I hope this will encourage more designers, the design community, to adopt this methodology for silicon success. Let's hope for that. Thank you again for joining me for the interview. And for our audience out there, if you are interested in knowing more about VC Formal, please visit our website. And I'll see you next time. Thank you.